To begin, you'll need a footage of the paper unfold animation, and I'm going to include this particular example that I'm using in the video description. So we begin by adding into the timeline to the video track number 1. Now if you scroll a bit forward, you'll see that this example has an additional background behind a green screen that we need to remove first. If yours doesn't have it, you can skip this step. So we go into effects window and search for ultra key, then we add this effect to the layer. Now in effect controls, we select the eyedropper next to key color and click on the background color to remove it. After that, we go back to the project window and drag the logo to the timeline one track above the paper crumple. Then we select the newly added logo and adjust its scale and position. And it's best if we scroll forward until the green screen of the paper crumple is fully visible. That way we can precisely align the logo inside of it. Then we right click on the logo and select nest. We can call this logo and click OK. We do this for the animation to work properly, and also this allows us to swap the logo for something else if we need to. Now we go back to the effects window and search for track matte key. Then we add this effect to the paper crumple. Then in effect controls, we scroll down to the track matte key, and in the matte, we select the video number 2. That will place the paper crumple inside of the logo. Now we need to duplicate this logo by holding the alt and dragging it one track above. Now we drag and select the paper crumple and the logo layer above it, then right click, select nest. I can call this paper, then click OK. Now we need to move the logo layer to the video track number 1, so let's do that. First move the paper one track up, then drag the logo to the video track number 1, and now we need to duplicate the paper layer by holding the alt and drag it one track up. Now we add the track matte key to the logo layer at the bottom, and again in the matte we're going to select the video track number 2, and lastly we need to key out the green color of the layer at the top. So we search for ultra key once again and add it to layer at the top. Now in effect controls, we select the eyedropper and click on the green color inside of the logo, and if you notice that the green color was not removed cleanly, like here you can see some parts, go into the matte generation and adjust the settings, usually dropping down the shadows work, so that's what I'm going to do. And here we have a clean paper unfold animation.